Really? Available in 3 to 6 stops. No, man, I cannot believe it. Bravo. I'm happy you found it. Yeah. Thanks. Guys, we need to talk. Looks minimalist. Yeah, it is minimalist. Here is the filter. Yes, my friends, finally someone made it. A variable ND filter with a useful range of ND stops. We are talking about 3 stops to 6 stops of ND filtrations. Amazing. Before we start, I would like to say thank you to Sandmark because they sent me the filter to test and make a review about it. But this is not a sponsored video. You will never see a sponsored video in this channel. So I hope you appreciate my honest reviews. I know that this brand can sound pretty new to you as well. It was new for me until a few days ago while I was searching for a variable ND filter for some documentary projects I have to work on in the future. And I found out that this brand is making a pretty useful variable ND filter, both for smartphones and now also for cameras. If you have absolutely no clue what is a variable ND filter, shame on you. It's a filter that lets you darken the image of your videos without changing the settings in your camera. If you're wondering what are the differences between a variable ND filter and a fixed ND filter, with a variable ND filter you're gonna have more flexibility, you're gonna be faster, plus you don't have to bring with you many fixed ND filters that they can add extra weight and take space from your camera bag. Who should consider this filter? I think every documentary and events filmmakers or YouTubers in general that they need to be fast and efficient during a shooting day. And I think also landscape photographers that want to be a little bit minimalist, they don't want to bring with them many fixed ND filters if they want to add some motion blur in their pictures. Of course, you're not gonna have the same image quality as a fixed ND filter, but if you want to use a variable ND filter, it's because of its versatility rather than its image quality. It's like considering a zoom lens against a prime lens. It's a comparison that doesn't really work. You use that zoom lens because of the flexibility. Is this filter better than the alternatives you can find in the market? Probably yes, because for the money you're gonna get a more useful range of ND filtration. I made the test for this filter with my Panasonic 20-60 that has a 67mm filter thread and the Zeiss 21mm f2.8 with a filter thread of 82mm. I apologize if I didn't use it with a 16mm lens, but I don't have it. But as far as I can see, there is absolutely no vignetting because of the slim profile of this filter. We are talking about a variable ND filter with a range of 3 to 6 stops with hard stops, so you cannot get the cross polarization problem typical from normal variable ND filters. As we can see, there is a little bit of color shift while we put the filter on the lens. It's going a little bit on the warm side, but it's not really a big problem because we can easily correct it in post. And don't forget that the most important thing is that we are not gonna get a color shift while we rotate the ND filter. Regarding the technology of the filter itself, is nothing new. It's working with a double polarizer filter that they are rotating in the opposite direction. So you're gonna get a darker image thanks to the cross polarization of those filters. So you can expect to have a little bit of cross polarization in the corners, like all the variable ND filters available in the market. The filter comes just with a tiny pouch and I don't mind it at all because the hard case is taking a lot of space in your camera bag, plus it's making that really annoying sound of maracas that I cannot really handle it. Sorry guys. Can I recommend this filter to you? Absolutely yes, because the quality that you're gonna get from this filter, it's pretty high considering the price, and you're not gonna have cross polarization in a range that goes from ND4 to ND5. And that's the sweet spot if you work with video. And if you like landscape photography and you want to add motion blur in your picture, an ND5, it's gonna be good enough to add motion blur in your images. Would have changed something in this filter? Probably I would have made the numbers more visible because it's pretty difficult to see them under sunlight, and I would have had a lens cap to protect the filter when you put the camera in your camera bag. Considering what the competitors are offering for the price, that would be a little nice addition. But this is it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comment area below, and I hope I'll see you next time. Ciao.